This video is brought to you by VIRCI, a science and technology company offering research and development and consulting. Welcome to the third episode of this four-book astronomy and astrophysics video series. This time we'll be talking about the Venus retrograde orbit. This Earth-Moon orbital two-way gravitational lock theory of the mechanism of the interaction of planetary bodies that is explained in the first episode of this series can be used with great simplicity, logic, and success to explain Venus's unusual retrograde orbit or clockwise axial spin and other anomalies in the solar system. All the other planets in the solar system spin counterclockwise. Venus's clockwise axial spin is a major anomaly. It can be observed that planet Venus, in its orbit around the Sun, orbits in parallel to the Sun's polarities, as all of the other planets in the solar system. However, because it faces a fixed direction when facing Earth during its orbit, it can be observed that Venus is locked in on a perpendicular axis onto a neighboring celestial body, or Earth. Venus is locked gravitationally on a second perpendicular axis onto Earth. Because Venus always faces Earth with its same side, in the same way the Moon is locked onto Earth through a second perpendicular axis or two-way gravitation lock as explained in the Moon chapter or in the first episode of this series. And this is why Venus faces a fixed direction during its orbit around the Sun, while its north and south pole axis is locked in parallel onto the Sun's polarity. If you'd like more of an explanation on the two-way gravitation lock, I would recommend watching the first episode. These observations led me to conclude the following hypothesis. As planet Venus approaches Earth in a faster orbit, it locks in onto Earth through a second perpendicular axis grip, and always through Venus's same side. Because of a quadrupole polarization in Venus's structure, the same as Earth's moon quadrupole polarization, this is what causes the same side of Venus to always face Earth. And as Venus is passing Earth, it is pulled into a retrograde orbit, or slow clockwise spin, because it is forced into a clockwise direction spin as it speeds away and gains distance while looking back facing Earth due to the perpendicular axis lock. This is due to Venus's perpendicular gravitational slash electromagnetic grip onto Earth, and Venus having a faster orbit around the Sun than Earth's orbit. There are two variations of Venus's perpendicular grip. It is not clear if the gravitational perpendicular axis lock onto Earth 1. Stays locked onto Earth throughout Venus's entire orbit around the Sun, or 2. If it loses the grip as it gains distance, as it moves away from Earth, and then re-locks onto Earth as it approaches Earth again. That is left to be discovered. But these two variations are very similar. However, further analyses need to be done to determine which is the more accurate one. Venus orbital facts. It can be observed that Venus completes a one-day rotation at exactly its closest point of encounter with Earth. Also, it needs to be factored in that Earth is moving in its orbit, and the point of encounter is always proportional to their orbital speeds and location. A mathematical formula of the ratios can be derived from their encounter points, orbit speeds, and orbit locations. Venus has an exact ratio of 3 periods of rotation to every 2 Earth orbits. 3-to-2 ratio between Venus's period of rotation and Earth's orbit revolution. That is proof of their synchronous orbits and gravitational grip. Every third time that Venus meets Earth, Earth completes 2 orbits around the Sun. That cannot be a coincidence. That is proof of their synchronous connectivity. This explanation for the cause of Venus's retrograde orbit makes logical sense and is self-evident and is the best scientific explanation available to date. Also, Venus and Mercury have no moons to create and complete the homopolar generator effect that creates the spin force on a planet's axis and magnetosphere, as explained in Why Planets Spin on Their Axis chapter or in the first episode of this series. Which is why Venus and Mercury do not spin on their axis in any significant speed. Venus is the second planet from the Sun, orbiting it every 224.7 Earth days. It has the longest rotation period of 243 days of any planet in the solar system and rotates in the opposite direction to most other planets, meaning the Sun rises in the west and sets in the east, if we're looking at it from Venus. It does not have any natural satellites. It is named after the Roman goddess of love and beauty, and it is the second brightest natural object in the night sky after the moon, reaching an apparent magnitude of 4.6, bright enough to cast shadows at night and rarely visible to the naked eye in broad daylight. Orbiting within Earth's orbit, Venus is an inferior planet and never appears to venture far from the Sun. Its maximum angular distance from the Sun, or the elongation, is 47.8 degrees. Venus is a terrestrial planet and is sometimes called Earth's sister planet because of their similar size, mass, proximity to the Sun, and bulk composition. However, it is radically different from Earth in other respects. It has the densest atmosphere of the four terrestrial planets, consisting of more than 96% of carbon dioxide. The atmospheric pressure of the planet's surface is 92 times that of Earth, or roughly the pressure found 900 meters or 3,000 feet underwater on Earth. Venus is by far the hottest planet in the solar system. With a mean surface temperature of 735 Kelvin, 462 degrees Celsius, or 863 degrees Fahrenheit. Even though Mercury is closer to the Sun, Venus is shrouded by an opaque layer of highly reflective clouds of sulfuric acid, preventing its surface from being seen from space in visible light. It may have had water oceans in the past, but these would have vaporized as the temperature rose due to a runaway greenhouse effect. The water has probably photodissociated, and the free hydrogen has been swept into interplanetary space by the solar wind because of the lack of a planetary magnetic field. Venus's surface is a dry desertscape, interspersed with slab-like rocks, and is periodically resurfaced by volcanism. As one of the brightest objects in the sky, Venus has been a major fixture in human culture for as long as records have existed. It has been made sacred to gods of many cultures, and has been a prime inspiration for writers and poets as the morning star and evening star. As the planet with the closest approach to Earth, Venus has been a prime target for early interplanetary exploration. It was the first planet beyond Earth visited by a spacecraft, Mariner 2, in 1962, and the first to be successfully landed on by Venera 7 in 1970. Venus's thick clouds render observation of its surface impossible in visible light, and the first detailed maps did not emerge until the arrival of the Magellan Orbiter in 1991. Plans have been proposed for rovers or more complex missions, but they are hindered by Venus's hostile surface conditions. This book is part of a four-book series, three of which are available right now on Amazon, Apple eBooks, and Barnes & Noble. Links will be in the description. Stay tuned and subscribe for next time, where we'll be talking about the dinosaur bonsai apocalypse.